In this part, we will continue working on ArcGIS tools, where we go to the second menu titled Terrain Morphology, and in it, we click on Drainage Area Characterization, a window entitled Drainage Area Characterization appears, and in it we go to drainage area and we choose catchment, and for them we choose extract dash fill one layer, where here the result will be added to the catchment layer table to the properties of each sub-basin table, which includes higher and lower point level, i.e. upstream and downstream elevation, inlet and outlet elevation, or inlet or outlet elevation. Then we keep the rest of options as they are. Then we press OK. We wait until calculations are complete for upstream and downstream levels of the sub-basin, of the sub-basins. Then a message appears indicating that drainage area characterization successfully completed. Then OK. Then we make a right click on catchment layer. Then open attribute table. The table appears with mine elevation for downstream and max elevation for upstream. Now we go to the third menu of the ArcGIS tools menu bar titled Watershed Processing, and in it we click on basin length points, where the benefit of this step is to determine the two points farthest from the centroid of sub-basin, that is to determine the upstream and downstream point, and in it we keep all options as they are, then we press OK. We wait for the implementation to complete. a new layer appears titled Basin Length Points, and we make right click on it, then open attribute table. A table appears that contains the inlet point or upstream and the outlet point or downstream for all sub-basins. As we see, it is worth noting here that the upstream and downstream elevations are present in the catchment layer table as we saw earlier, where we can also find the upstream and downstream elevations by going to the Arc Toolbox window, and in it we go to Spatial Analyze Tools, then to Extraction, and we choose Extract Values to Points. Then in the Input Point feature, we choose Basin Length Point Layer, and in the Input Raster we choose Extract Dash Fill 1. Then we go to Output Point Features, and we specify the place of preservation in the file of a project. And in it, we make a new folder titled Inlet Outlet Elevation. Inlet Outlet Elevation. Then we open this file, and in it we type the file name, then we click Save, then we press OK. Then a message appears indicating that extract values to points successfully completed. Then we make a right click on extract-basin-le1 layer, then open attribute table. The table appears including the elevations of inlet for sub-basin and outlet, as we see. So inlet and outlet elevations are now present in the extract-basin-le1 layer and catchment layer, where the elevations of inlet and outlet in the catchment layer are adopted.